Walking among his prized herd of dairy cows, Nick Haddow is in heaven.
Kia ora, Mum. Hello.
The man appointed to lead the new Brand Tasmania set up this dairy to provide milk for his famous Bruny Island cheese.
All of our cheese has been made from this milk for the last couple of years, and it's utterly changed the nature of our cheese, and which has been fascinating. We've had to sort of almost relearn what we do.
A stone's throw away by the banks of the Huon River, we discuss Nick's passion for cheese and Tasmania itself.
Nick, this is God's country.
It's nice here, isn't it?
not bad at all.
It's pretty relaxing. I love coming down here. I think this is Tasmania to a T. You know, natural beauty, beautiful produce, you know, great people, and this is not hard to find. You know, this is a typical day in Tasmania, I've got to say.
There's also Nick's passion for his new role as chair of a supercharged Brand Tasmania. One that's both exciting, if not a little daunting.
To carry on from the work that's happened in the last 20 years with Brand Tasmania Council, which has operated essentially on the smell of an oily rag, achieved amazing outcomes despite the lack of resourcing, and to be able to ramp that up, that's a huge job. So I'm freaking out.
There's no doubt that Nick is living proof of Brand Tasmania in action. His incredible handmade cheeses, a taste of the best this island has to offer.
Lovely. I'm going to hoe into something, so I can't resist. What's this one here, Nick? So
this is one of our hard cheeses. This is George. So, you know, this comes from the girls, the herd of cows that's just over in that paddock over there. So this is, it's quite a simple cheese, but it, you know, as a cheesemaker, what I'm interested in doing is making cheese that absolutely reflect where they come from. So this is a unique Tasmanian cheese. This is a cheese that can't be made anywhere else in the world.
It's a taste of heaven in a little slice of heaven.
I think the world wants what we've got. The world responds really well to this. You know, these places are few and far between these days around the world. And to be able to offer that in a way that is still safe, still clean, still accessible, interesting, great food, incredible scenery. Why wouldn't the world want this?